Hello, my name is Daniel, and in this short video I want to show you some scripts which name essential objects and all the deformers in Cinema 4D just like your selected object. Okay, first take a look at how we install the scripts. We simply jump into our scripts menu and here we choose script folder and the scripts library of Cinema 4D opens, and here you simply copy the scripts into this scripts library of Cinema 4D R20. I did it for this video here as our namer essentials and our deformer namer. And if you jump into the deformer namer folder, you will find a file like this, which is called deformer namer palette. And you can simply drag and drop it into your Cinema 4D window. And we want to do this also with the namer essentials. Here you find a file which is called palette namer essentials. Simply drag and drop it into your Cinema 4D window, just like this. And as you can see, now we are ready to go. Our palettes are ready and we can fold the palettes by simply right clicking on them, fold palette. And of course, we want to do this also for our deformer namers, fold palettes. And then we can simply open window customization, customize commands. And here we simply choose edit palettes and we drag and drop the namer scripts palette like this into our top palette and the band namer also. Okay, that's it. We are ready to go. And of course, make sure you save this as startup layout or as your own layout. So in this case, I save it as startup layout. And then I just want to show you how the scripts work. So I open another scene. Okay, here we are in our scene, and as you can see, we have some objects here and they need a subdivision surface generator. So the old workflow would be, we simply select the object and then we choose with Alt key. So you hold Alt key on your keyboard, the subdivision surface from the generators menu. As you can see, the subdivision surface is called subdivision surface. And if we select another object and select a subdivision surface generator, this is also called subdivision surface 0.1 in this case. And with our scripts, there's something different. So let's undo this, select the object again, and let's select an SDS namer generator from our scripts. We hold Alt, of course. And as you can see now, this generator is called just like your selected object plus how the generator is called. And in this case, it's a subdivision surface generator and it's called SDS in this case. And if you select the other object here, the small device plug, and hold Alt and simply click at your SDS namer generator, this one is called just like the selected object. So here is something different, and you can automatically call your objects or your generators just like your selected object. And of course, this is also working for splines. So you can choose your cable circuit spline in this case, and we simply generate an extrude generator here. And as you can see now, this extrude generator is called just like the selected object plus how the generator is called. And of course, this is also working for deformers. And in this case, we want to hold Shift on our keyboard because the deformer needs to sit underneath the selected object. And in this case, I choose maybe, yes, this explosion deformer. And as you can see now, this deformer is called like the selected object plus how the deformer is called, and in this case, it's explosion. Wonderful. And you can simply work with our scripts just like you would work with the old menus here, but it isn't possible to select more than one object. As you can see here, I select all the objects and then hold Alt and create subdivision surface generators for them. If we do it with our scripts, we select all the objects and hold Alt and create a subdivision surface generator, we get this message here and it says, please select one object. So you can only select one object to create the generator here. Because the scripts need to know how the object is called, and if you select more than one object, the scripts doesn't know how the objects are called. But of course, this is something for the future. We can implement this for the future, so you can select more than one object and they are all named correctly. Okay, I think that's it. I hope you can enhance your workflow with the scripts. See you soon and goodbye.